Welcome back everyone to theCUBE's live coverage here in San Francisco. I'm John Furrier, host of theCUBE. Wall-to-wall coverage here on the big day at the Databricks Data Plus AI Summit. Data intelligence platform is the core product. That's the core infrastructure of the data. Of course, the new products, apps, the OLTP, native AI format, which we love, but also agent bricks, getting all the buzz as people see where the data value extraction is, also creation as well. Where the creation really is on that infrastructure. Our next guest, Jonathan Keller, VP of Product Management, has the keys to the kingdom to that area. Jonathan, great to have you on theCUBE. Thanks for coming on.
Thank you so much, I appreciate you having me.
So Unity Catalog seems to be where the unification is. That's where that magic is happening. Yeah. Data, if you look at, you squint through all the enthusiasm, which is deservedly high, especially with agent bricks, which really simplifies things. Yeah. And a lot of the plumbing stuff. I love Lakeflow.
Thank you.
ELT automation, democratization. But Unity is where the action is. That's where the data kind of gravity is.
Yep.
And that's independent, abstracted from where it's stored. A lot of customers love that.
Yeah, absolutely.
Because now they don't have to worry about storing it on infrastructure that's tied to the lake. They can.
We'll go get the data wherever you want to keep it, whether it's in OLTP databases, whether it's in another data platform or data warehouse. Unity really does unify across all of your data state, regardless of platform, engine, format, all those things.
So talk about the cataloging and the indexing that goes on. It's an end-to-end platform that you guys have. Explain Unity Catalog and where that fits in.
Yeah,
and the whole platform piece.
If you think about Unity Catalog, and it was interesting, I don't know if you caught Jamie Dimon this morning.
I did.
He talked about with data and AI, the AI is the easy part, the data management is the hard part. And Unity Catalog was really created to solve those problems, right? You know, customers don't want to have to worry about formats, they don't want to have to worry about being locked into an engine or capabilities. And Unity provides this layer that manages all of your data, wherever it is, provides unified governance, so in the best of governance. It's not like, you know, we give it the row, the column, the attribute-based access control, all of the core capabilities, regardless of data format, and then customers can focus on adding value and achieving things with their business, not making copies of data around platforms.
So talk about, what is the big shift, if you had to point to the marketplace customers, because there's always been this kind of like sentiment, and maybe it's generated by the media and the vendors in the marketplace, but you guys have been on the North Star of open. We've been following Databricks from day one, so we can kind of say that. But there really isn't a battle per se, because there's a rising tide. So last year when you guys open sourced or created the tabular deal and then Iceberg came into the mix, it was a sigh of relief, but then the industry rallied around that moment.
Absolutely.
What is this shift and why is it important?
Well, I think if you look at the history of the industry, most of the major data warehousing products out there make their money by locking you in, right? Even till today, it's like proprietary formats, proprietary storage, proprietary engine, and they don't really want interoperability. But in this, you know, age of AI and big data, like even these customers, they can't ignore it, right? Customers are demanding interoperability, right? They don't want to be locked in. They want an open platform. They want to use the latest and greatest AI tool that comes out. And so it's driven this shift, and it's been great to see the community partner and things like that. And so it's been great progress.
Has it been mainly that the customers don't want to be forced through a proprietary platform, or is it more of that they just don't want to move stuff around? Or
it varies obviously by customer, right?
Yeah.
But I think the main thing is, in this world that's moving so fast, you can't afford to be locked into one particular tool or capability, you know. And look, I get it, it's good for business, right?
Yeah.
But like, it's not good for the customers.
In open systems, lock in like that doesn't work.
It doesn't, right?
Value lock in, where you have value, is great.
We're very happy to compete with anybody on value. Saying, oh, I can't access your data, that's kind of silly.
Yeah.
Right?
So there's two things we're covering in our research of theCUBE. Value creation, value extraction. Customers can do both. You guys can create value to be extracted by the customers and partners. As you look at your products, what products do you have under your group, and where's the key value creation, and how are the extractions on the customer side extracting that value?
I mean, Unity Catalog is an interesting piece of that, to be honest with you. what we're seeing with our customers that have made the journey, and the vast majority of our consumption is now through Unity Catalog, something like 97% of customers or something on it, they move faster. And they're getting more done. Like, they get to focus on getting AI into production, not figuring out where the data lives, right? And so, like, just from a bullet, it's interesting to see.
Or building pipelines.
You know, it's funny, like, you know, catalogs, it's a simple concept, but it was missing in the enterprise, right? And so filling that void has just driven so much customer satisfaction and value. And we see it customer after customer after customer. They just get more done because, you know, whether it's eliminating processes or ETL pipelines or copying data, but they can actually focus on value generation themselves, and we're just enabling that.
Okay, so I guess my question would be, what does data infrastructure mean when you say you run the VP, you're the VP of product for core infrastructure?
Yeah.
What does that actually mean, like, from a product standpoint and capability?
Yeah, so if you think about our whole, the Lakehouse strategy, there's a few fundamental horizontals to our product. Those are capabilities that are surfaced in everything, right? Delta and Iceberg as a core storage capability is within my team, and we lead that area. Unity Catalog, of course, and then security and identity and those kinds of things that allow us to serve the most regulated of customers like JP Morgan and others.
Yeah.
That's kind of within, you know, within my purview. And then I support all the other product lines, whether it's the Mosaic AI capabilities, it's, you know, even extending governance to Lakebase now with the OLTP side of things.
So what does the product roadmap look like for you? Because again, the feedback we hear is people love Iceberg.
Yeah.
They store in Iceberg format, a lot of leverage out of that, great integrations, analytics are great.
So there's two big, within the infrastructure area, there's two big investments, and Matei is going to cover a lot of this. We're excited about the keynote tomorrow. One is around just fully making Iceberg a first-class citizen. And I think we have the Unity Catalog is now the best catalog for Iceberg management. You know, read and write to it from any engine, fine-grained governance applied regardless of engine, a lot of core great announcements and capabilities around that. We even added something that was lacking, which is sharing of Iceberg across organizations. And so now anything in Unity
across
Catalog.
Across environments.
In fact, environments and clouds and regions, right? So
that's a great
you can share data out of Unity Catalog into a partner or a customer in another cloud in Snowflake and another region, those kinds of things. So there's a lot of announcements around just saying, hey, we're done. Like, we did the Tabular acquisition. You know, we've got the creators of Iceberg, the creators of Delta, the creators of Parquet in the company building a great end-to-end solution that just solves that.
By the way, a lot of people didn't think that was possible.
It's been amazing, and honestly,
I
want to say it's been amazing to see the partnership in the industry.
Yeah.
Right, like Iceberg committers from Snowflake and AWS and others have helped support some of the changes that have really driven interoperability. So it's been great to see the community partner around this interoperability.
Yeah, I mean, it's a rallying. I mean, and when you have growth markets rallying around things is really consensus driven.
Oh, absolutely.
It's not dogmatic vendor speak.
No.
When you say, hey, this has value, if we just kind of salute the flag, if you will, we start with Kubernetes and platform engineering.
Yeah, and it's, when I think about Iceberg 3 v3, which was just accepted by the community a couple weeks ago, it really does. Like, there's some really good parts from Delta that were accepted into Iceberg, like deletion vectors and things like that. And there's good capabilities from Iceberg that are now part of Delta 4.0. And so the formats are really just becoming a thing. No one has to worry about it anymore.
Yeah, it's a relief, actually.
Amazing, yeah, absolutely.
All right, so where's the action happening? Okay, that happened, check the box. I'm sure there's some maintenance
there, but
what's next? What's being built on top of it?
The next big pillar of announcements is we're seeing Unity Catalog. You know, customers are just demanding that we fill this void of connecting Unity more with the business. And what I mean by that is like semantic modeling capabilities, internal marketplace, discovery of data, really connecting and having Unity be a representation of their business, not just their data. Semantic models is probably, Unity Catalog metrics will be go out to the whole public tomorrow. It's a unique capability. You know, a lot of customers have built semantic models and they're doing it, but they're doing it in the BI layer and it's not usable anywhere else. It's locked into Power BI or Tableau.
I actually was watching the keynote. Like, I think Jamie Dimon actually said semantic layer.
Yeah.
Did he? He actually said that.
Yeah.
I'm like, oh.
But it's you know.
He gets it.
We can do just such a better job of doing that at the data platform layer. So Unity Catalog is releasing its metrics layer and capabilities tomorrow as well. You know, and that just adds, you know, a lot of dimensions. And we've done a really good job making sure all the AI surface areas, like Genie rooms and things like that, can understand those metrics. And it really helps you really, you know, business users get much more out of the catalog and answer trusted business questions.
You have some pedigree, obviously, Microsoft, Google, now Databricks. Platforms have a characteristics. successful platforms.
Yeah.
They enable. Yep. But they also, it's a disruptive enabler when you're in new markets where you have an unknown future.
Yeah.
And that's kind of where we're at. Jonathan Franco was just on last hour, and he was talking about the old computer science days. It's like, the programmers didn't know what to do. They've had all now new speed. So in a lot of ways, there's a lot of unknowns, and this is good. So
yeah,
what's going to come? What is the enablement in your mind as you look out we see agent bricks? You
know, obviously, I see it from the platform capability, and the big thing is just making sure that you'll see in the demo tomorrow all these platforms, Snowflake, EMR, Trino, DuckDB, all being able to use Unity Catalog as its source of truth for governance. And that extends to AI tools and platforms as well, like Unity connecting to MCP servers and things like that. And it's really just about maintaining that optionality so that as the market evolves, customers aren't forced with a false choice of what to do with their data and how to govern it and how to leverage it. And Unity brings that governance. So we see customers really struggling with AI because most of the market does AI as a bolt-on, right?
Yeah.
And so, you lose all your governance the minute you go into the agents, right? And with Unity, that extends through, right? So you're not getting access to data you don't have access to just because you used a chatbot or a RAG app or something like that.
Yeah.
It's all unified.
I was here before I came on to do my marathon 12 to 6 podcasts here with all the top people. Could be fatiguing. The brain power here. I just keep my game up, and I'm not even had a cup of coffee yet. I saw a financial analyst, and they're new to Databricks. I want to run this by and get your reaction.
Sure.
This person asked me, just kind of a question, eyebrow raised. Databricks, wow, all these people are here. They're only doing like $4 billion or so. Like, they're not really doing a lot of business. What's happening? So it's kind of more of a question of why is this so popular? So. And I'm like, well, because they might not be doing the revenues of like the big, companies that have analytics businesses, but they have the mind share of the enterprise. They have a developer community. What's the magic of Databricks? Why are there so many people here? You've seen many waves of innovation.
What's your
personal perspective? And because my take is, the future is development and data and AI, and it's not a revenue game. So explain why it's not about the revenue.
Having worked at two of the other clouds, I can tell you it is a radically different environment within the company, right? It is ridiculously customer focused. Like the hundreds of customer meetings a week, all the information is shared, and we really do react, right? We're not beholden to anything. Iceberg's coming along, great, let's pivot to Iceberg, right? There's nothing sacred in the company, right? If the customers and the market is moving, we're going to go after it and we're going to do a great job at it, right? If you think about it, Databricks as a lakehouse, the data's open, it's in the customer's storage, they can use any other platform with it. Like, our differentiator is that we're good and we run fast and we deliver value.
Well,
there's no moat, there's no lock-in, right?
Moat is actually a defensive term. Implies walls.
Yeah, right.
Why do I need a moat if everything's free?
Exactly.
Come in.
Even Unity Catalog, it's free. We don't charge for it. Like, well, that's not the point.
Well, I think, and this is where I want to riff with you on this, because I think one of the things people squint through, so I try to figure out where the puck is going, but to me, innovation is the key metric.
Yeah.
Here's where the innovation's happening. Again, the future is unwritten, it's being written now. You have data is where the action is, and as the infrastructure, large scale system clusters from the NVIDIAs and the AWS and the Azure of the world, as they get more horsepower, more tokens, and more GPU cycles, that will unleash a massive data infrastructure. This is our thesis. I'm sure you guys believe in that too, that's why you're doing it. What about the infrastructure do you have to focus on as a product leader to maintain the stability as the rocket ship hits escape velocity?
There's a couple things that definitely focus on. One, of course, is security and governance and privacy and that kind of stuff, right? In this world, and as these companies are trying to use new agents and AI and capabilities, right? They need to make sure they're protecting their customers' data and their own internal data, and that's a big part of what we do, is to make sure that as things move fast, but it's still secure and governed, right? And then the other piece is really just the data intelligence piece of helping them actually make the best use of the data that they have, right? Yeah. And that's where a lot of the core capabilities come in. Like, we see how your data is joined, we see how it's leveraged, we see where it came from, and that allows us to really just provide acceleration of development and things like that.
So, final question for you. Share the platform evolution perspective just in the past few years. You've been in Databricks on the product side. You got Mosaic AI, Agentbricks with Tao now, just had Jonathan on, he's super pumped. Yeah. Unity Catalog with Metrics, Lakeflow.
Yeah.
I mean, this is significant components.
It's amazing progress.
Scope the progress in the past couple of years of the platform evolution. What, in your, how would you describe it?
I mean, I think, you know, I'll speak just because of my areas of the strongest,
of course,
right?
Yeah.
If you think about the adoption of Unity Catalog in a B2B enterprise market, to go from not existing to 97-98% of our customers using it, to the vast majority, like, that is unheard of.
That's product market fit, I think.
Like, that is amazing.
Yeah,
like,
you know, I put the math on that, right?
At Microsoft, we used to joke if you had anyone using it in 6 months, it was a success, right?
Yeah, like, but champagne for everybody.
And so it's been really rapid adoption and great product market fit, to your point. And so it's unprecedented. It's really amazing. Like, the markets that didn't exist were now in and growing. And when I think about the OLTP and the Lakebase announcements, like, that is a market that
and
is
the full support
right
for Apache, Iceberg and Delta Lake.
Yeah,
I think that's a pretty big deal too.
Oh, absolutely. Like, it really does eliminates that last hurdle across interoperability with platforms, and so
all
customers
right.
can really
final question, because it just popped in my head when you mentioned Lakeflow, migrations.
Yeah, absolutely.
Huge part of modernization.
Absolutely.
Also a grind in some areas because brittle infrastructure. Some data sources don't have the.
Yep.
Sometimes the interfaces to get the data out.
Yep.
This is a big challenge for the enterprise. How do you look at bridging that migration?
Well, with a new product called Lakebridge.
Lakebridge, yeah. Sound familiar?
So I think, you know, we did an acquisition of Bladebridge, which was a company that had a lot of good tooling for like sizing and assessments, and they've done thousands of migrations with us, right? And so that's one core piece, and the other piece is bringing our own Mosaic AI research team to it. So you're going to see a part of Lakebridge, some core AI components. It turns out translating from one SQL to another or from one Python library to another is a pretty solvable problem in today's world of LLMs. And so we've got a great research team that is solving that and really just accelerating.
And AI helps with tooling too and helping
absolutely.
That.
Absolutely.
So that's got the tailwind for you guys
on the
product
side.
Yeah, so
the Databricks SQL business in particular is where we're seeing just huge takeoff of people leaving their old on-premise or even cloud data warehouses behind and moving to Databricks.
Ali did say that you guys are doing a lot of coding with AI in the Anthropic interview.
Yeah.
Same on your side too?
Absolutely, it's heavily adopted within the ecosystem.
All right, for the customers that are watching or prospects to Databricks and your customers, anyone in general, what does data intelligence in action look like? We've heard some from Virgin Atlanta came on, we had another customer, a partner on SAP Databricks, that got the Australian bank coming on next. What does success look like?
I mean, the reality is what customers see is faster time to value. It just comes down. I think Virgin Atlantic, you can mention weeks to days, that kind of thing. You know, there's brilliant models out there for anybody can generate text to SQL these days, right?
Yeah.
But doing it with knowledge of your platform, your data, how your tables are joined, what your semantic models are, that's really unique to Databricks right now.
Yeah.
It's first class in terms of its ability to accelerate development.
I got to say, when we launched our super cloud vision a couple years ago, Databricks had the above the cloud paper, which is kind of a North Star, and kind of the vision staying true.
Yeah.
Data's on top of the infrastructure.
Yeah,
that's the
absolutely.
Cloud.
It's where the value is, and it's where the innovation is.
Where are you optimizing for? What's your goals in the second half of the year? Just share with the folks, what are you looking to do? Looking to hire, obviously, growing.
Yeah, I mean, we're continuing to grow. I think, the Lakebase execution and getting that from the public preview where it is today to GA, fully integrated with the platform. Like, I mean, we've been working on it for a long time. This wasn't a reactive acquisition. This was a big plan to go big in this market. I think that's one of the core pieces, of course. Apps is just a new frontier, right? The ability to build your app and have all the governance and all the data access and all the AI, you know, these are going to be just explosions and use cases.
Generative apps are coming.
Absolutely, yeah.
Jonathan, thank you for coming on theCUBE. Appreciate it.
Great to
Jonathan's
be here.
He's got, the keys to the kingdom when you got the product management and product roadmap of Databricks. Obviously, great success here and their launches of new stuff and continuing to innovate. Of course, theCUBE is doing its part, sharing that with you. Thanks for watching.
Thanks.